guys. Today is Tuesday, April 20th, and as you might have noticed, I got my hair cut. My sister Candy, then my sister Lacey, then my mom, they all got their hair cut, and I decided I wanted to join in on the fun too. So I went and got mine chopped off, I don't know, it was about to maybe here, or actually it was getting pretty long, and so I just cut it, a lot of it off. And I'm really liking it, and it's really nice. So there's that. Anyway, so back to stuff I'm actually going to talk about. A couple months ago, OpenGen hosted a block drawing thing. I don't know exactly what to call it, but you made a block that's a batik block on, here's just one of mine for an example. You took batik fabrics and you did a paper piece block on some black fabric. There we go. That was a tongue twister. So anyway, I made a whole bunch of them, and my sister Lacey made a couple, and she won all of the blocks, and I was really jealous because I was like, I wanted to win, because I really like winning. So she was very, very nice after I begged her, and she gave me all of the blocks. So I have all of these awesome batik blocks. Well, they're not enough to make, you know, exactly what I wanted to make, so I decided I needed to make some more blocks. So this weekend, I decided to do some machine embroidered blocks. And I have a lot of them, and I'm not going to show them. There's going to be pictures at the end, so it's not just me holding up saying this one, and this one, and this one. But I'm going to go ahead and point out a couple of my favorites. This little seashell one right here. Sorry. There's a seashell one right here. All of my blocks that I embroidered on, I decided not to. I just sort of randomly put some fabric on most of them, like this one. I just got some pieces of black fabric and then just sewed it on, folded it over, sewed it on. And so this one just has sort of like three really uneven corners, and I think it's really fun. And then this is one of my other favorites. It has bees on it, and it is awesome. The bees are just a really great design, and I like it. This one right here is, there's these little hearts in different colors. And I think it turned out really cool I snipped it up and then sewed it together, and it turned out, you know, pretty nice. My favorite embroidery design is the York design from Urban Threads, and I use this one a lot. What I did, I just thought, I'm like, well, I really don't want to put a border around it because it's, you know, a tall design rather than a wide design. So I took a piece of black fabric and just sewed it right down the middle of the piece. So I think that turned out pretty fun. Let's see. There's this one I did stitched up two little lamps and then just put a black border between them. And then this one is the skeleton key design, and I really like how this turned out. You can't see the colors perfectly, but you will in the pictures, and I don't know why, but these colors are just, love them. So, and then there's this last one. So, after I did all of those, I counted the blocks, and I realized I'd miscounted, and so I had one too many. So instead of taking out one of these blocks, I decided to make five more blocks, because obviously that's the logical thing to do, of course. So I made some paper piece blocks, and this is the chocolate frog pattern from OpenGen. This is the Harry's Lightning Bolt version 2 pattern. And then these two are my pattern. They're my patterns. You can see them on the guest designer page of Sewhooked. And then there is this one. This is also from Sewhooked by OpenGen, and it's the Crazy Daisy. So I think that turned out really, I just blew it up about 200%. So I think, I kind of wish I would have done black in the center there, but I still think it looks really cool. And I think that's all, so I'm going to go ahead and leave you with the pictures, and I'll see you next week. Bye.
Be done, you're crazy!